In this lecture, we are going to discuss about three-phase bridge inverter. It consists of six thyristors T1, T2, T3, T4, T5 and T6 and six diodes are. So these diodes are connected anti-parallelly with the thyristors. Here Vs is the DC supply voltage. So across the supply, a capacitor is connected and this is a three-phase loader. So this load may be either star connected load or delta connected load. So this three-phase inverter can be formed by connecting three single-phase inverters in parallel. And for providing adjustable frequency power to industrial application, these three-phase inverters are commonly used. And the DC supply can be given either by a battery or a rectifier. So it consists of six thyristors and six diodes as already discussed. A large capacitor is mainly provided at the input terminals to make the input DC voltage a constant value. And here there are two possible patterns of gating the thyristor. In one pattern, each thyristor conducts for 180 degree. So this is also called as 180 degree mode of conduction. And in another pattern, each thyristor conducts for 120 degree. So this is also called as 120 degree mode of conduction. So first we will see three-phase 180 degree mode voltage source inverter. So in this mode, each thyristor conducts for 180 degree. Thyristor pair in each arm. So that is T1, T4, T3, T6 and T5, T2. So these are thyristor pairs. So if we see the circuit diagram, this is one pair. The thyristor is connected to the same arm forms a pair. So here T3, T6 and similarly T5 and T2. So these thyristor pairs are turned on with a time interval of 180 degree. So that is T1 conducts for 180 degree. So once T1 is turned off, T4 will start conducting for another 180 degree. That is T1 and T4 will be conducting alternately. Similarly, T3 and T6 and finally T5 and T2. So these thyristor pairs will be conducting alternately in a cycle. So now we'll see the switching sequence of the thyristors. So thyristors in the upper group, that is T1, T3 and T5, conduct at an interval of 120 degree. So that is, if T1 is fired at omega t is equal to 0, T3 must be triggered at omega t is equal to 120 and T5 should be triggered at 240. Okay, this is triggering sequence. So the thyristors are triggered at a 120 degree interval. Okay, whereas the thyristor will conduct for a period of 180 degree because this is 180 degree mode of conduction. So this is true for the lower group of thyristors also. So now we'll divide into 60-60 degree interval, 0 to 60, 120, 180 and so on. So now let us assume that at omega t is equal to 0, T1 is triggered. Okay. So once T1 is triggered, it will conduct for a period of 180 degree, okay, 0 to 180. Okay. So now as we have already discussed, T1 and T4 forms a pair. So after T1, T4 will start conducting. So it will again conduct for a period of 180 degree. So if you see here, we are triggering T4 at 180. So it will conduct till 360. So after T4 again, T1 will be conducting. After that, T4. Okay. So this forms one pair. So now the next triggering sequence is T3. Okay, T3 must be triggered at omega t is equal to 120. So at 120, we are going to trigger T3. So T3 will be conducting for a period of 180 degree. So 120 plus 180 will be 300. So till 300, T3 will be conducting. So as we have seen already, T3 and T6 forms a pair. Okay, so after T3, T6 will be conducting. So again, T6 will be conducting for 180 degree interval. So after T6, again T3. So after T3, again T6. So here before T3, T6 was conducting. Okay. So next, T5 is triggered at 240. Okay. So at 240, we are going to trigger T5. So this will conduct for 180 degree interval. So now T5 and T2 are in pair. So after T5, T2 will be conducting for another 180 degree interval. So again, after T2, T5 will be conducting. Similarly, here before T5, T2 will be conducting and here T5 will be conducting. Okay. So if you see here in between 0 to 60 degree intervals, these three thyristors are conducting T1, T6 and T5. Okay. So in 180 degree mode of operation, at a time, three thyristors will be conducting. So one from upper group and two from lower group or vice versa. Okay. So if you see in the next interval, that is from 60 to 120, again, three thyristors will be conducting T1, T6 and T2. Okay, T6, T1, T2. So this is the sequence. So again, during the next 60 degree interval, here T1, T3 and T2. Similarly, here T4, T3 and T2. And here T4, T3 and T5. And this is in between 300 and 360, T4, T6 and T5. So this is one complete cycle, okay, from 0 to 360. Okay. So again, here the next cycle will start. So this will get repeated here. Okay, if you see here, T1, T6 and T5 will be conducting. So the same sequence as that of step one operation. Okay. So again, this here in eighth step, step two will be repeated, 6, 1 and 2. So similarly, here T1, T3, T2. Here T4, T3, T2. So next T3, T4, T5 and finally T4, T5 and T6. So here two cycles are given. So now we have to derive the line voltages and phase voltages. So now we'll consider step one operation, that is in between the interval 0 to 60 degree. So here already we know that the conducting devices are T5, T6 and T1. Okay. So here if you see the circuit, T1 and T5 are the upper group thyristors and T6 is the lower group thyristors. Okay. These three thyristors will be conducting. All other thyristors are in the open state. Okay. T1. T5 and T6 are conducting. So now let us assume a star connected load. Okay, this is a three phase star connected balanced load. So this phase A is connected to this T1. So again, T1 is connected to positive terminal. So phase A is directly connected to positive terminal of the supply voltage. Phase B is connected to the negative terminal. And phase C is connected again to the positive. So A and C are connected to positive. B is connected to negative terminal of the supply voltage. Okay. So now we can redraw the circuit. Okay, A and C connected to positive, B is connected to negative. Okay, this is neutral point. So let us assume I1 is the current flowing through the circuit during step one operation, that is from 0 to 60 degree interval. So if we see here, these two impedances are connected in parallel. So on simplification, we get Z into Z divided by Z plus Z or Z by 2. So this is a equivalent impedance. So this Z by 2 and Z are connected in series. Okay, so the same current will flow through Z by 2 and Z. So now current I1 is given by total voltage divided by total impedance. Here the total voltage is Vs, total impedance is Z by 2 plus Z. So on simplification, this can be written as 2Vs divided by 3Z. Okay. So now our aim is to find out the phase voltages and line voltages. So the phase voltages are VAO, VBO and VCO. So here these two are in parallel. So VAO will be equal to VCO. Okay. So this is given by I1 into Z by 2. So I1 2Vs by 3Z into Z by 2. So ZZ and 2 will get cancelled, remaining terms VS by 3. Similarly, VOB. So here VOB is written as I1 into Z. So 2 VS by 3 Z into Z, that is equal to 2 VS by 3. So but in actual, we want VBO. So VBO is equal to minus of 2 VS by 3. So next, we have to find out the line voltages. Line voltages are VAB, VBC and VCA. So VAB is VAO minus VBO. So VAO is VS by 3. VBO is minus VS by 3. Minus 2 VS by 3. So already we have minus here. So plus 2 VS by 3. That is equal to VSR. So next VBC is equal to VBO minus BCO. So minus 2 VS by 3 minus VS by 3 equal to minus VS. And finally, VCA is equal to VCO minus VAO. So in this case, both are equal. So it is 0. So this is for step 1 operation. So next we'll see step 2. Okay, this is in between the interval 60 to 120. So here the conducting devices are T6, T1 and T2. So T1 is connected to, T1 is the upper group thyristor. T6 and T2 are lower group of thyristors. Okay. So at a time, 1 from upper group, 2 from lower group, or 2 from upper group and 1 from lower group will conduct. So again, if you see here, phase A is connected to positive terminal, phase B is connected to negative, and phase C is also connected to negative terminal of the supply voltage. So now we'll draw the equivalent circuit like this. Okay, phase A positive, B and C are connected to negative. So now let I2 be the current flowing through the circuit during this step. These two are connected in parallel, so this can be simplified to Z by 2. So I value will remain the same in all the cases. So I is given by total voltage divided by total impedance. So Vs divided by Z by 2 plus Z, that is equal to 2 Vs by 3 Z. Okay. So now we have to derive both the phase voltages and line voltages. So phase voltages VAO, here VAO is given by I2 into Z. So 2 Vs by 3 Z into Z is equal to 2 Vs by 3. Similarly, VOB. So here VOB and VOC are same. So I2 into Z by 2. On simplification, it is Vs by 3. So actually, we need VBO and VCO, that is minus of Vs by 3. Similarly, we have to find out the line values. Okay, VAB, VBC, VCA. So the formula is same. VAO minus VBO will give you VAB. So already we know VAO and VBO. So on simplification, we will get Vs. And here VBC will be 0. And VCA will be equal to minus Vs. So this is for step 2. Similarly, we have to derive for all the other steps. So step 3 is in step 3, that is from 120 to 180 degree interval. So again, 3 thyristors will be conducting T1, T2 and T3. So here T1 and T3 are upper group and T2 is a lower group. And phase A and B are connected to positive terminal of the supply voltage. C is connected to the negative terminal. So this is a equivalent circuit. So the procedure will remain the same. Let us assume I3 as the current. Here these two are in parallel. So the equivalent impedance is Z by 2. So current value will remain the same in all the steps. 2Vs divided by 3Z. So then as usual, we have to find out the phase value and line value of the voltages. So here VAO and VBO are same. Okay. So given by Vs by 3. So here VOC is given by 2 Vs by 3, VCO is equal to minus 2 Vs by 3. So similarly, we have to find out VAB, VBC and VCA. Okay, here 0 plus Vs and minus Vs. So this is for step 3 operation. So next is step 4. Step 4 also, we have to repeat the same thing. So okay, 182, 240, these devices are T2, T3 and T4, conducting devices. Again, T3 is upper group, T2 and T4 are lower group. Okay, A is connected to negative terminal, B is connected to positive, and phase C is connected to negative. So this is a equivalent circuit. Let I4 be the current flowing through the circuit. Here, the equivalent impedance is Z by 2, current value same. Again, we have to find out the phase voltage and line voltage. So now this is the overall table. So here step 1 means 0 to 60 degree. Step 2 means 60 to 120. Step 3, 120 to 180 and so on. Okay. So first 3 are the phase voltages. Next 3 are the line voltages. Okay. These are the values which we have derived. Okay. Vs by 3 minus 2 Vs by 3. Vs by 3 Vs minus Vs 0. So this is for step 1. Okay, similarly for the other steps also, we have to derive in the same method.